The wait is over, and my 8Bitdo 64 Bluetooth controller has finally arrived in the mail from Amazon, and my initial impressions are great. Being a huge 8Bitdo supporter, owning an N64 as a kid, and as someone who is always on the lookout for ways to improve my overall retro emulation experience, I knew I had to pre-order this when I saw it advertised a month ago. Though I would probably consider myself first and foremost a PC gamer, and generally use a mouse and keyboard for modern titles, I do have a large controller collection. Most of these devices are USB, 2.4 wireless, or Bluetooth in order to use when emulating consoles on PC. Most of them are also made to imitate older first-party controllers. Having a well-built and comfortable controller that matches a similar form and button layout to original console hardware is one of the best ways to enhance retro gaming emulation. Before I dive into specifics with the 8Bitdo 64 Bluetooth, keep in mind that this is not really an unboxing or hardware review channel. Any footage I add to this video will likely just be through my low-res webcam or VOD footage from my stream, so I apologize for the quality. Also, I will be looking at this purely from a Nintendo 64 emulation experience on PC, such as how to get it set up and working with the Mupin 64 core through RetroArch, or how it performs overall. Finally, this is a fully unsponsored video, though I guess I can always dream, right? Give me a call sometime, 8Bitdo. Nintendo 64 emulation has a pretty rocky past, and even to this day it can still be a bit of a headache to get everything working perfectly on certain devices. Likewise, there also haven't been that many great options for USB or wireless controllers with an N64 button layout. With that being said, I do want to give a big shout out to the Retro Fighters Retro Brawler 64. It's certainly not a perfect controller with its squishy trigger buttons and high price, but overall it's not bad, and was my go-to joypad for N64 emulation, that is prior to the 8Bitdo 64 Bluetooth of course. The Nintendo 64 has remained a favorite of gamers ever since its release in 1996. But as of late, it seems to be undergoing a popularity spike of sorts. At the time of creating this video, the Analogue 3D has just released and is currently sold out on the official website. For those unaware, the Analogue 3D is basically a modern version of the N64 and 4K resolution using hardware, that is, no emulation involved, and is compatible with all original games and accessories. Analogue teamed up with 8Bitdo to create the 64 Bluetooth as the official controller for this new console, hence why these devices were released side by side and appear together in promotional material. All you have to do is plug in the controller through USB to the Analogue 3D, and it will download the appropriate firmware automatically, allowing for Bluetooth connectivity. Nintendo themselves have also been expanding their Nintendo 64 Classics collection on the Switch and Switch 2. The 64 Bluetooth controller advertises out-of-the-box compatibility with Windows, Android, Analogue 3D, Switch, and Switch 2. This brings us to the large elephant in the room, and that is the current relatively low Amazon rating for the controller, especially for an 8Bitdo device. I do not have a Switch 2 to test this, but apparently the controller is not working out of the box with the Switch 2, and requires you download a firmware update from the 8Bitdo website in order for it to work. As far as I can tell, this minor inconvenience is the only complaint I've seen and is single-handedly responsible for their review bombing on Amazon. It makes it difficult to paint a clear picture for someone like myself who would be purchasing this controller for emulation use solely on PC, so hopefully this video can provide a better understanding of the controller than the Amazon reviews do. The 8Bitdo 64 Bluetooth controller is currently $39.99 USD on Amazon and comes in either black or white. I feel that this is a pretty fair price point, all things considered, especially since the Retro Brawler 64 is $50 and is of a much lower build quality. The 64 Bluetooth is made with a Hall Effect joystick that is all the rage currently, and means that it should last for a very long time and pretty much eliminate any kind of stick drift. The joystick cap is basically identical to the stick that was present on the traditional N64 controller. Furthermore, the face button size and positioning is made to be just like the N64 specifications. It also comes with turbo button functionality and has vibration support when used with the Analogue 3D or Switch consoles. As I mentioned earlier, I got this controller pretty much strictly to use for N64 emulation on PC. However, I do have an original Nintendo Switch and decided to connect it to the console just to see how it worked for this video. I do not currently have a Nintendo Online subscription, so I couldn't test the controller out with the N64 Nintendo Classics collection, but everything seemed to connect right up after I moved the back switch to S on the controller and added it through the Switch menu under Change Grip / Order. There were no issues connecting, everything was responsive, and all of the buttons seemed to work how you would expect. Now, as for connecting it to my PC to play N64 games through the MuPen 64 core on RetroArch, I was a bit worried at first. Setting up controllers in RetroArch can be a very finicky process that doesn't always go the way I hope it does. Sometimes profiles don't save correctly, other times you need to use different controller drivers, occasionally the wireless connection behaves differently than the wired connection, and so on and so forth. I was very pleased when it took me virtually no time at all to get the mapping set up exactly like an original N64 controller. I will briefly cover what I did to get this working, in case some of you are having issues. Feel free to skip ahead using the timestamps if you are not a RetroArch user. First off, make sure the back switch is set to the D mode and then connect either with USB or Bluetooth to your PC. RetroArch should recognize the controller, but give an error stating that there is no profile found. From here, you need to set up the button mappings in Settings, Input, RetroPad Binds, Port 1 Controls, Set All Controls, using your keyboard to navigate here. Follow a logical button setup. However, you will want to swap the A and B buttons and assign the RetroPad right analog stick directions to the corresponding C buttons on the controller. Your page should look like this when finished. Alternatively, I will provide a link to download this exact controller profile in the video description and show where to place the CFG file. Afterwards, be sure to save controller profile and then exit RetroArch through the menu and restart it to make sure these mappings saved. Next, you will need to create a core remap file for the MuPen 64 core in the Quick menu when a game is loaded through the core. It will then be located under Quick menu, Controls, Port 1 Controls. In here, you basically do the same thing, but now you are translating the RetroPad bindings over to the core bindings by selecting each input. Once again, swap the A and B buttons, and towards the bottom, you will again assign the right analog stick to the corresponding C buttons, as well as make R2 another Z input. It should look exactly like this when finished. Again, I will include my MuPen 64 core remap file and provide the location for it in the video description. If you do it manually, be sure to save the core remap file before exiting and then restart RetroArch so that it sticks. In order to test these included files, I downloaded a fresh copy of RetroArch and placed both of them in the correct locations, and everything worked perfectly, so I recommend just grabbing them from the links below. After using the controller for a few days and testing out a variety of different N64 games across multiple genres, I gotta say I am very happy with this product. It feels excellent to hold and has a very aesthetically pleasing quality to it. It is what I would personally consider to be the perfect weight and balance. My hand seems to just naturally fit around it comfortably and intuitively. It somewhat reminds me of the Nintendo Switch Pro controller, which I've always been a fan of, but with that 8Bitdo flair and of course the classic N64 button layout. I particularly love the recreation of the N64 stick cap, combined with a modern Hall Effect joystick. The original N64 controller was actually a bit awkward to use at times, and the stick got worn out fairly quickly, so it's nice not to have to worry about that anymore. I can't say much about the battery life since I generally just play wired to avoid any hiccups, but I did try it over Bluetooth for about an hour and didn't notice any input lag or random slowdown or disconnects. 8Bitdo claims that the battery can last up to 36 hours on a full charge, which is pretty impressive. The first time I played Super Smash Bros. With the 64 Bluetooth, I felt like I was playing at the top of my game and actually surprised myself with how well I did. I of course can't say for certain this was because of the controller, but I certainly didn't perform as well last time I played prior to owning this device. In addition, playing through games like GoldenEye and Star Fox 64 has been a real treat. The aiming and navigating felt as smooth and precise as ever. I actually found myself wanting to play N64 more so than usual. In closing, I think that the 8Bitdo 64 Bluetooth controller is a wonderful addition to the 8Bitdo library and for my personal controller collection, and it is without a doubt my current go-to for N64 emulation. The build quality is great, I had no issues connecting it or mapping the buttons, and it is a wonderful modern take on one of the most iconic retro controllers. I highly recommend it. Don't be fooled by all of the negative Amazon reviews from Switch 2 owners who think they wasted $40 and don't realize they just need to download a quick firmware update. I hope you found this video informative in helping make a purchase decision for the 8Bitdo 64 Bluetooth controller, or it assisted you in getting set up in RetroArch with it if you happen to already own one. Eventually, I would love to make another video on controllers for emulation and basically cover all of the popular retro consoles and give my personal picks for which controllers I would recommend using for each one. So let me know if that is something you would like to see. I should probably also make a more in-depth RetroArch tutorial on how to create custom controller profiles at some point. I could honestly talk about controllers for a long time, so I'm sure there is much more to come. Consider subscribing to the channel if you are interested in topics such as retro gaming and emulation, or catch me live at twitch.tv/watsonator. Thank you for watching, and good night.